Let me exchanged for the pawn for the knight. I think we have in quite a good position. If you have plus six. Okay, now what? Now I see an option to fork these two pieces. Thinking about queen a1, but that was the checkmate. The other option to play. All right, now let's take the bishop. And now what can we? Okay, let's check first. Then we can capture the pawn. All right, not really now. Let's play rook e8, so basically block the whole pass for the white king. Limit is same movement options. Okay, this move, yeah, not really. Okay, I think, let me check and see what happens, because he cannot move. Okay, we check one more time, and now we will be able to checkmate. All right, yeah, that's it. Nice. So let's go to the next spot. Okay, now Fendi from Canada. Nice. So 150, actually 1500. exchange. Yeah, and the risks here and that. Let me just take it. And now, what options here? Nothing much, I would say. I don't know what is the whole point of this move. Okay, if I capture the pawn with the weapon, I'm attacking the knight. Yeah, okay, that's a bit risky. Can check. Yeah, I need to take, but also I will take the rook here. Yeah. Okay, I think we are doing well. Let's just push the pawn. I think you cannot play with all the bots if you don't have the premium or I don't know, one of these paid subscriptions. So I had to switch it here. Okay, let's move to the next bot, and this is exactly the same ranking. Are they the same? I don't know. France, beer. Okay, let's play E4 and see. I wouldn't say I see this move too many times. I don't know whether I should take it actually. Maybe I should. I think I can push further. Yeah, I don't know whether it's a right move or wrong move, to be honest. But this point seems like a decent move to me. Like, I'm always about pushing the pawns further. Okay. Let's bring our knights first. Well, if you do the analysis in check and chess, you will reasons it prefer to. The ancient prefer to take the knights out first. And I don't really know exactly the reason always. And to be honest, like chess engines, it's really hard sometimes to understand it because it calculates it so precisely that, yeah, like human mind cannot really take the whole point there. Okay, but I don't know how this game is going, to be completely honest. I think I can, if I capture this knight, after that, no, I can put my knight here, but is there any advantages of my knight being on b5? I don't know. Alright. Looking for some interesting move, but I don't see any. I have to look for this opening actually. It seems like a decent one. I mean, at least I don't see a lot of people playing it, so it means that not many people know the theory at my level. Okay. It's a bit tricky, to be honest. I'm a bit stuck. Okay, let me. I want to capture this knight. I don't like it here. And I was thinking what I can do with my knight on c3. Alright. Now. Yeah, like, this is an option here. If I attack the queen, you can basically defend, so yeah, it doesn't really make sense. Okay, I think this is the best move here. Just make our bishop a bit more active and force the black queen to retreat back. Okay, I think now I'm obsessed with this move for some reason at this game. Doesn't really help. I have this move. Just okay. I was thinking about f4, but I just lost the pawn. I need something that will defend mine. I need another attack to the f4 square, and my rook is in a, yeah, not the best position. Okay, it's actually a bit more difficult, I would say. Yeah, let me push my pawn. Let me push my pawn. Could have played. Okay, let me take it. Even though I'm playing with whites, I think I had a disadvantage in this game. I mean, it looks okay-ish now, but beginning. Yeah, I capture it because there's a discovered attack and he runs away. I have to be careful because the queen is looking here, and if the bishop is also helping the queen, I can just lose it. Okay. I can capture the queen and I'm one pawn ahead. Shouldn't have moved the bishop. Actually, if I capture his queen, this bishop will not be defended, so I can, yeah, take it. Okay, yeah, let me think a little bit. Maybe I should capture it and later on move my bishop somewhere. Yeah, maybe I would have preferred to move it to f4, but yeah, I can't. Okay. Now, I think it's time to bring the bishop to the game. I think it was defending for too long. Now it's time to activate it. The same score for the second rook. Let's bring it here. Rook toward the, OK. Because that's a real threat, actually. He can evil check if I run away. He will capture that bot. And here, the issue is there is a checkmate in the move. And another option for me will be just to block it. But in that case, bishop to d3, and there is nothing I can do about it. Okay. I should push the pawn further. Yeah, let's see what happens. Wow. I'm just doing it first. Okay, it is defended. What should we try here? Let me do it this way. I don't know what they're gonna play. I think I can try to do something. Okay, now So I can check. Let me first check. And now I can check one more time. If someone attacked this pawn, okay. Now we're attacking the pawn. Right, yes. Alright. But it's defended anyway. Okay. Maybe something like bishop, I think. Yeah, I'm losing my bishop here. I probably lose the game. Okay, I think I lost it. That's funny. That's interesting. Yeah, we will come back for the revenge. Anyway, thank you for listening. I hope you enjoyed it. And see you on the next video.